Father in heaven, as you have so richly blessed the work of our hands, we now ask you to receive the fruit of our hearts in the name of Jesus. Amen. In our prayers this morning, we remember our brother Gordon Gates, who just recently had a fall and broke his hip, is recovering, but is struggling with all of this. And so we extend our prayers to God on his behalf. I invite you to please rise and turn to page 20. We join in the prayer of the church. Father in heaven, we thank you for all of the blessings that you give us in life, blessings that are sometimes hard to recognize. The blessings that we know by your promise are there. We thank you for your guidance. We thank you for your providence in every situation, and the promise that in all things, you are working for our good, the good of those who love you. We thank you for Gordon, his life, for the blessing that you have given to him, and the blessing that he has been to this world. And we thank you for your actions in his life even now, which we may not understand, and he may not understand. We thank you for the healing that you have given to him and that you will continue to give to him. We ask that you heal him completely, and we ask that you give him peace of mind as he considers his life, as he considers where he is, what he has to deal with. But above all, we ask that you strengthen his faith in you, in your promises, both now and for eternity. We ask that you comfort him with the knowledge that he is yours and will always be. One day he will see your face and all of the glory that you have promised. We ask that you strengthen all of us to this end. So many suffer. So many don't understand why this world is as hard as it is, or even what they are dealing with. We ask that you give us insight into ourselves, into our problems, but above all, faith in your love and in your wisdom. We ask that you comfort us with the knowledge that you will never leave us or forsake us. We ask all of this in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. As we continue with our next hymn, 497, This Is My Will.
Thank you.
Lord, you have given us your holy scriptures for our learning. May we so hear them, read, learn, and take them to heart, that being strengthened and comforted by your holy word, we may cling to the blessed hope of everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Please be seated as we continue with our final hymn, 250, All That Dwell Below the Sky. Consider that. If you have any more questions, talk to me or Minister Dan. He's not here, but when he's back, then you can talk to him. October 19th to the 21st, a marriage and enrichment getaway weekend. This is going to be held in Suamico for the simple reason that it's supposed to be a getaway where you can leave your kids, where you can leave life behind and just enjoy that time with your spouse and consider the mystery that God has given us in marriage, this tremendous gift. It should be a very enjoyable weekend. I know I went to one with Rachel. I will be leading this one, but I went to one that another man led, and it was worth every moment. So please consider that. as you seek to strengthen that gift that God has given to you. And then one other thing that's not printed here, but it is up there. You may know this, in a week and a half, the mobile Vietnam Memorial Wall is going to be coming to Crivitz. And this is a huge event. And we expect thousands and thousands of people to be coming to Crivitz for this. And we would like to facilitate. It's a very emotional moment and perhaps a very difficult moment for those who remember the sacrifices that were made. And what we would like to do is to open up our church for anybody who would like to just come, pray, or to talk. What we are planning on doing is having people here from noon to 10. There will be two, our plan is this, and I'll try to keep this short, to have two people here just to greet and say, welcome, make yourself at home. And if you would like to talk, we'll be in the back. Now, if you're going to do this, know that you don't have to counsel them, you don't have to be a psychologist. We're going to have things printed out so you can simply read a Bible passage or say a printed prayer. And if there is more that is needed, either Minister Dana or I will be here this entire time. But it will be hopefully a way that we can open our doors and God's heart to these people and share God's love with these people. Next weekend, in place of Bible study, and again after the second service, we're going to be talking a little bit more about what we're doing. So if you're intrigued at all or think you might like to help, please stick around and we'll talk more about what we're going to do. So if you have any questions, though, please talk to me. With that, God's blessings to you today and throughout the rest.
Yes.
We did some fishing. We did out. We spent a few days on the water and two buses. Sometimes it gets to your head. You're heading back to school pretty soon?
Last week, August is my start classes.
Okay, last week. Oh, so you'll be here next Sunday?
Yes.
Okay, well, not next Sunday. Yeah, just talking to Rev Shep. He's going to be preaching here that week at the Camp Bird. So.
Oh.
Everybody's sick of seeing him at all.
I'll be about 15, 20 minutes before I get over here. I'll see you next girl then.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, by the way, congratulations on 20 years in ministry.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Doesn't seem like it. Still trying to figure out what I'm doing.
There's nothing here this time.
Yeah.
How could this be? We're 10 months.
Remember, I can tell you this. You can appreciate it. You went after the first year of ministry. They all brought us back to Synod. And I was honest about this. I still feel like I guess that's okay.